people at the bottom of the pyramid who deserve as much, if not better, treatment than those who can afford it. Once again, thank you very much, sir, all of you. I don't know what to say. I am really overwhelmed with the kind of love and respect you all have given me. But I hope I deserve it. I hope I can do something. And I'll do my best. Thank you so much.
Dr. Anil Kakodkar, a famous nuclear scientist, former chairman of Atomic and former secretary, Department of Atomic Energy, Government of India. He has published more than 250 research papers. He believes that India should be self-reliant in energy, especially by the use of cheap natural thorium resources. For his extraordinary contribution to the field of nuclear science, he has been honored Padma Vibhushan by the Government of India. I kindly request him to address the gallery.
Walawalkar, all other colleagues on the dais, off the dais, and friends. Every time I come to Durban, I feel as if my batteries are getting charged. And I'm sure by the time I leave here in the evening, I will go fully charged. Durban, I think, is a, you know, we keep on talking about the right ecosystem for achieving different kinds of objectives. I think Durban is one such ecosystem. Which is holistic in my view, and it is getting enriched day by day in terms of the psychological setup for service to mankind, in terms of creating new things so that we can do that service better, and in terms of, as I said earlier, adding all the dimensions that could allow you to do that service in a somewhat holistic manner. And so, as we heard, it began with health service, it began then, it went on to training, education, different kinds of education, school level education, training for nurses. Now we have the medical college. And of course, the impact is not restricted to just this institution, but the entire neighborhood. And in so doing, of course, people here are continuously fully involved, making great efforts. But there is a large network, large number of people from all over. They come here and participate in this major mission which is taking place here. And I'm sure all of them, while they contribute to the mission and objectives of this place, they all must be going back with their batteries charged, as I said myself. This particular exercise, there one biomedic initiative. I'm very happy that this has taken roots. This is one place where the medicos and engineers have come together and will continue to work together. This is one place where engineers originally from biomedical engineering and technology field, would be able to get some genuinely hands-on feel of the impact of what they do, and also about understanding what they should be doing in the future. They could interact with the medical people to understand the requirement of development in this area. They could interact with the locals, because this is in a rural surrounding, to understand the genuine, quote unquote, user requirement. And similarly, the medical people, they can spell out their difficulties, requirements, present their ideas as to this is the way they expect this to be done. And so, I think it's an environment, it's an ecosystem for a true synergy. Synergy between people, synergy between disciplines, synergy between developers and users, and so on. Many times, a lot of developments do happen in labs. And I can say that for sure in the context of at least areas which I am more familiar with. We do that development, showcase it in a variety of ways, through papers, through exhibitions, through some limited demonstrations. And then we feel that yes, you have that satisfaction of having done something very useful. A very large number of them do not actually see the light of the day in terms of the spread and deployment in the user domain. On the other hand, there are many others where the ideas emerge from grassroots, and they may not be people who may know the technology at its best, but they are well rooted into the problem, passionate about solving them, so they solve it somehow. And I'm not saying that you get the best of technology through such a route. But I have seen examples where such developments at least spread somewhat wider. I don't say that they spread very wide, but they spread somewhat wider compared to the quote unquote supply driven developments which many times take place in the lab. And so I think there is this great need, in my view, to bridge the so-called demand-driven effort and the supply-driven capability to supply. And I think this particular event would significantly contribute in that. The mention was made about the 70% people living in rural areas. I think we should also recognize that on an average, the income, individual income of these 70% people is one third of the average income of the remaining 30% people who live in urban areas. But at the same time, the urban area are the people, the rich people, regardless of whether they are in urban or rural areas, they constitute a huge market. A huge market that can pay. And so, most of the development which takes place is essentially, these investments in development, investments in R&D, particularly with a pure so-called business orientation. It takes place looking at the market, and so it's no wonder that this development is actually sort of moving in the direction of catering to the needs of urban people, because that's where this market is big. They may be 30% of India, but this market is far bigger than most of the rich countries. They often say India is a poor country where maximum number of rich people live. And whatever you see happening in terms of the international interest in India is in fact driven by this large market that India offers. I don't know if we go into that subject, but the fact is that there is this big driver for deciding the directions of development. That necessarily does not help the larger part of India. The larger part of India is those 70% people who live in villages and where the income is small, the connectivity is poor, access is poor. So there are far bigger challenges. And so I think it is important that if we have to serve this larger part of the community, I think we must be driven by needs of these people. So we must be driven by an ecosystem which enables us to understand the needs of these people and also enables us to evolve the right solution. I think Derwent, with its sort of already established activities for several years and the capability that has been already built here and the new medical college that has come about, offers us an excellent host for actually nurturing an ecosystem where we can drive this development which is more consistent with the needs of quote unquote real India. And I think I would imagine that that should be the central focus of whatever we are trying to do here. Now that does not mean that something which is useful in cities is not useful in villages. Most of the time it is. It does not mean that the best of technology which has been developed in the West is not useful here. Most of the time it is, and that's how the technology spreads. But the point is that in contrast with so-called quote-unquote multi-speciality infrastructure where people can go and get all kinds of services, and India certainly offers that. India is an important destination for health tourism, so obviously all the features are existing in India. But it requires people to go there. The poor people in rural areas, particularly in remote rural areas, in fact cannot manage to go there. And so it's important that rather than people having to go to such multi-speciality institutions, it is the multi-speciality service or the high-tech service that must reach the doorstep of people wherever they are. And that means an entirely different kind of technology. Thankfully, with the developments that are taking place now, that indeed is becoming possible, and we know several things have emerged which actually facilitate this process. And I think so those are the areas which probably deserve greater attention, and I'm certain we're going to see many of such things being displayed here in this exhibition now, but we hope to see many more of such things in times to come. I must also mention that even the multinationals, whenever they chalk out their kind of strategy, business strategy for future, the last few years are actually turning their attention to this segment. And that is because although the urban India with rich people offer a very big market, people have now realized that these poor areas where the affordability is probably not all that high at individual level, but collectively, because the numbers are very large, because there is a large unmet need, collectively it actually offers even bigger market. And so many multinationals are in fact now allotting greater priority to cater to the needs of this unmet sector. For us, in an education and research domain, I think it's very important that we are able to sort of create such an initiative. It's of course good for meeting the needs of the country, as I said earlier, but I think it's also very important in terms of the upbringing of our students, young people. It's important in terms of experience that they should gather. So it actually contributes significantly to the education and research objectives. So I think it's a quote unquote win-win situation for everybody, and I must congratulate everybody.
Thank you. where physicians and engineers have to come together. So this event is also a means to reach the rural people. Thank you, sir, for your inspiring words. We have come to the end of the program. I request all the dignitaries to proceed to the exhibition hall. This event will be commenced by having the ribbon cutting in the hands of Dr. Kakodkar. I request all the dignitaries to proceed to the
Yes.